What's up, guys? This is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure that you hit that like button and subscribe for more video content. In this video, I am answering, or really, I guess, collaborating with my viewers here, because they gave me some questions or some problems that they've been having with buffering and clipping with a with multi-line layers. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is the problem that they've been having is with the CRS. And with their CRS, as you know, when you pull up, usually when you pull up a default layer, the layer will have degrees here, okay? And all of these over here are in degrees. But they want to make a buffer in meters. And one of the comments said that it wasn't an error, and they were trying to buffer polylines, but no matter what projection, the buffer is more like looks like a billion meters or something like that instead of 10 meters. Okay, so what I want to do is show you guys how to get that on down on your multi-line. So I actually went ahead and created a multi-line layer here, multi-line strings. And I just drew one out here. Now I'm gonna go ahead and add a few more of these because I want to make sure that there are multiple examples so we can use, did I click the button? Yeah. So we can use a couple of these. Since it's multiple, we can do multiple. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and do an example of a regular buffer on these three lines. Now these three lines are all in degrees, and these three lines, I'm using the US back here as kind of like a sizing, so you can see the size compared to something. So let's go ahead and go to vector. We'll go to our geoprocessing tools and we'll go to our buffer. And we'll go to, actually, you know what, did I, no, I don't need to select them, they're all in the same layer. The dialog box has other options here to be used, and it should not just be one degrees. So let's go ahead and run this. We'll leave everything as it is and run this, and we'll see that we get some nice pictures here. And we'll pull them up a little bit, and so we see our lines over the buffers in degrees. So let's go ahead and we can take these and we can put them, I don't know, we put them down here, I guess. Alright, so let's go ahead and do our reprojection. So we have our lines here and we'll go ahead and reproject. So let's reproject these lines, or reproject the layer, the entire layer. And of course, I did not select any because I'm just going to do it on all three of the multi-lines that I have there. And we'll go ahead and take them over to the pseudo-mercator. So we'll reproject these lines as pseudo-mercators, okay? And this will change them to the units, or the length unit of meter. And if you don't have these in your drop down, you can hit this little button here and type it in and you'll be able to get to it. So you just type in exactly what I click on right here and click on it and make sure that we have the right layer selected, which it is ML1, and we'll run this. Now we'll get us a nice reprojected layer. Now we can actually take this one down because now we have our reprojected layer, and guess what, the reprojected layer has meters. Okay, it's in meters. So now what? Now we want to create a new buffer that is, let's say, 1 kilometer, or let's do 10 kilometers in length. So we'll go ahead and create that. So we'll go to vector, we'll go to geoprocessing tools, buffer, And we'll go out to, now we see our triangle is gone and we have meters, kilometers, whatever. So we'll go to 10 kilometers and we'll leave that as 10. And go ahead and, I mean, we could do meters since we're in meters. So, I mean, I guess we can do meters and we'll just do, no. Let's just go ahead and do, let's just stick to what we got. Let's do kilometers, 10 kilometers, and we'll run this. Okay. So as you can see, our lines darkened up, but that darkness is not just darkness. It is a new buffer. Okay. So these buffers, if we zoom in here, you'll see that our buffers are, let me get my little measurement tool and bring them down here. And let's see if we can measure this kind of correctly. I can't get it directly on there. Oh well. Well, anyway, it's about 10 kilometers across. I can't get it directly on there because my hand's too shaky. But anyway, yeah. So that's basically how you do your meters. But another thing I want to explain. Let's back out. And when you're doing this reprojection, so you see how you can see like the United States and India and all this. These are in different CRSs. Okay. So whatever you do to these, it will have no effect on the CRS of the pseudo Mercator. And what I mean by that is it's almost like the CRS is the visualization point or how it is digitized onto the canvas. Okay, if I were to change the entire project CRS, it would literally change how these layers here, like this one, would digitize onto the canvas. Right now they are still digitized within their own CRS. Okay, but let's say if I went to my project CRS, I went to properties and I changed the entire project, and now take a look before I do this and see how it looks, and now watch what happens when I change the entire project CRS. So I change it to, where did I go? Properties. And I'll change the whole project CRS to pseudo Mercator. And I'll hit apply. And I'll hit okay. Now, look at this shape. Does this shape not look different from what you just saw? Okay. It's gonna look different. Now, how do we circumvent that, I guess you can say? You could go here to your layer and you could try something like this. You could say, okay, well, let's set this to project CRS, or no, let's set the layer CRS. It should already be on pseudo Mercator, but it is, let's see, is it? It is not, because the length unit is still, where's my length unit? In meter. Let's change this to pseudo Mercator. And hit OK. And this is what happens when you change a layer that is not meant to be digitized in a specific CRS to that specific CRS. It is no longer visible because it cannot be calculated. Okay, the reason that these guys can hang around is because these guys, remember that I reprojected them beforehand to be in this CRS. Okay, so I can't go here and try to change this. So if I say set CRS, set layer CRS, it's already there. It's already in the pseudo Mercator, so of course it can be visible here. Now, let's say if I wanted to bring the others back, all I would need to do is reverse that process, okay? So whenever you're doing, let's say, like I just created the buffers that are a meter, 10 meters or whatever they were. I just created those buffers, right? They are digitized and calculated by the specific CRS in which I created them. Okay, so if I created them in pseudo Mercator, then they will be visible in pseudo Mercator. If I created them in WGS 84, then they will be visible in WGS 84. It doesn't, they can't jump around. This is why we have to reproject the features and the layers that I have, the features and the layers that I have created. So whatever you are using, make sure that that CRS is the layer CRS, and if you want it to be the total CRS, if you only want those specific features to show up, use that CRS. So anyway, I did this as a kind of like a answer and a question thing. So if you guys have any questions about what you just saw, please ask me in the comment section. The problem that he was having such big buffers, but when I zoom into my buffers that I just made, I can clearly see them around. So where's the line that I had? If I lift this line up, that line is right there. I don't know if you guys can see it. Let's change that line real quick. Let's change that line so you guys can see it a little bit better. Perfect. I mean, I can barely see it. Okay. So there's our line right in there. And around that line was the buffer that I put in there. So if that was our road, these two outside lines would be kind of like our sidewalk. Okay. So if that's what you guys were trying to get at, if that's what you guys were trying to do, please let me know in the comment section. If I got it completely wrong and you had a totally different question, please let me know in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.